Hey guys, this is Carly with Johnny32, and this is a new video for today's post. Before I continue, I just want to let you guys know that I am not a prophet, I am not a pastor, women pastors are not biblical, I'm not an apostle either. I'm just a fumbling servant of the Lord who's here to share what the Lord shares with me based on His truth, which is His Bible, and being led by His Holy Spirit, which I pray and hope that I'm always being led by His Spirit. So I am baptized in the Holy Spirit. I do speaking tongues, among other prophetic gifts. That in itself is biblical. A lot of Christians are walking with that anointing. And for more information on the spiritual gifts from the Lord, I encourage you to read 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and 14. If you have any questions regarding this message, I definitely encourage you to pray to the Lord and just wait for His revelation and confirmation. So, this message, I got this message from the Lord a few days ago in my spirit, and I have to say, as I wrote this post today, you know, I prayed to the Lord to give me the right scripture and the right message for all of us, and including myself. And this really spoke to me, so I wanted to address that because, you know, you and I, God is not a respecter of persons, and God loves us. But at the end of the day, you know, He's called us for all of us to be holy, to be spotless before Him. Okay, so I want to address that because I definitely do not want to come off that I am holier than thou, than the next person. I see so much in the church. It's disgusting. I'm so sick and tired of this self-righteousness approach and attitude of so many Christians that they think that they're spotless and blameless and that they're not committing any sins. And you know what? The reality is we need to come to repentance and obedience with the Lord every single day, because God can call us home at any moment. And the Bible clearly says that without holiness, no one will see the Lord, that we must work at our salvation with fear and trembling. And this message here is so loud and clear, and it just confirms so many of the things that are going inside the body of Christ right now, and that why we need to be careful. And this specifically is what the Lord Jesus spoke to me on the 19th. It's what comes out of the mouth that defiles, okay? Church, this is very, very important that we need to be careful. We need to guard our mouths. So I'm going to take you to scripture, and I'm going to give you a list of sins that our mouths tend to do without even knowing it. And just bear with me on this. I'm going to be 150% real with you. And also everything that's on this message is supported by the Bible. This is all that I read. I only read the Word. I don't read CDs. I don't read podcasts. I don't read teachings of men. I read the Word of God, because the Word of God is fire and it's a hammer. It breaks chains and it gives you the truth. The Jesus is the truth, the way, and the life, and the Word is power. So in this final hour, it behooves us to get into the Word of God and be led by the Spirit of the living God. All right, so in Matthew 15, verse 18, it states, "But the things that come out of a person's mouth come from the heart, and these defile them." In Proverbs 13:3, it states, "Those who guard their lips preserve their lives, but those who speak rashly will come to ruin." If you go to Romans 3:13, there it states, "Their throats are open graves, their tongues practice deceit, the poison of vipers is on their lips." Okay, as Christians, all right, so if you are watching this and you are a Christian, especially if you are a truth and spirit believer, okay? Hear this, pay attention. We must take the plank out of our eyes first, and let's examine if our mouths defile us daily. Below, like I stated earlier, you're going to find the list of, if you go to this post on Facebook, you're going to find a list of all the sins that are abominations in the Lord's eyes. And if you see yourself, including myself, if I see any of these sins, or if you see any of these sins and that you're committing them, as a sister in Christ, I cry out to you to please, let's just go to the Lord right now, repent, and sin no more. Truth. The Word of God states that without holiness, no one will see the Lord. So we must get off this notion that because we're Christian, that we are exempt from the Lord's rebuke. God is not a respecter of persons. And as Christians, He is holding us to a higher standard. The Word of God says that if we are guilty of any of these things, unless we repent and sin no more, we are headed straight to hell. God is love, but He's also a righteous judge and a consuming fire. If you know that your mouth is going to bring destruction in people's lives, that it's best that we just keep it shut and we ask the Lord to give us His heart, His eyes and ears, and also to ask the Lord to teach us His ways and His thoughts so we will stop sinning. Here's a list of things that I can tell you I've been a victim of. So let's just be mindful. Whether we've been a victim of it or we've been a culprit of the sin, okay, these sins are in common practice day in and day out from our mouths. So it is best to be vigilant and keep this in mind, not to use our mouths to curse or to bring destruction, but we should use our mouths, like the Word of God says, is to exhort, to edify, to encourage, and to warn in truth, in love, and in spirit. Number one, word curses. Okay, for those that do not know what a word curse is, a curse can be defined as the use of powerful words to invoke supernatural harm. So curses can be human or divine, oral or written, personal or collective. Okay, I've been a victim of word curses before I was a Christian and even after being a Christian. And the sad part is I've gotten word curses from other Christians. That is a heinous, disgusting sin, and it has to stop, because I come across so many Christians and they're receiving word curses from other people who are Christians, word curses against their ministries, against their marriages, against their callings, against their anointings. That is a pure, disgusting, acne flesh of the devil, that we cannot call ourselves Christian when we're using our mouths to throw word curses. If that is you, please repent, sin no more, and ask the Lord to cleanse your mouth and not to do that anymore. The second sin, blasphemy. We all know what the word of blasphemy is, but I'll give you the definition. It's the act or offense of speaking sacrilegiously about God or sacred things, profane talk. For those that do not know, there are a lot of Christians, especially from the Baptist faith and other denominations. I'm not here to create division among denominations, because we are all called to be truth and spirit worshipers of the Lord. This is His truth. We are to be baptized in the Holy Spirit so we can worship the Lord in truth and in spirit. But see, what I've noticed here is, here in the Bible Belt, there are a lot of Christians, specifically from the Baptist faith or the Methodist faith, or perhaps Episcopalian or other faiths, is that they don't believe that speaking in tongues is biblical. So one of the things I've heard in the past is that they say that speaking in tongues is devil talk. If that has been you, you need to repent of that immediately, because you are going against God. Okay? Speaking in tongues is biblical. And it's one thing when it's one thing when you can attack a Christian, but when you're saying blasphemous things against the Holy Spirit, you are walking in very grave danger. So once again, repent. A lot of people, including non-believers and Christians, they say the word God and then the D word afterwards. That is a sin. Or sometimes, you'll see movies, or you'll see TV shows, or you'll hear people say Jesus and then Christ in a negative, profane word. That is blasphemous. If that is you, ask the Lord for forgiveness, repentance, sin no more. The third sin, heresy. Heresy is the belief or opinion contrary to orthodox religious Christian doctrine, usually Christian doctrine. If you are a pastor or a preacher or an evangelist or a person who's supposed to be preaching the word of God, but if you're saying things outside the word of God, that is a heresy. There are a lot of heresies going around. So if that is you, please, once again, you're messing with the Lord. Repent and sin no more, because that heresy coming out of our mouths is, it's an abomination in the Lord's eyes, and it needs to be corrected immediately. Please repent and sin no more. The fourth one, seduction. The action of seducing someone. Men and women alike, whether we're Christian or non-Christian, a lot of them tend to use their mouths to seduce people. If you are a child of God, man or woman, and you are seducing people with your mouth, okay, and also, sexually flirting, especially with a married man or a married woman, you need to repent of that immediately, because you are being guilty of lust. You are being guilty of what can lead to fornication and adultery, okay? We cannot, as Christians, we cannot use our mouth to seduce people from the opposite sex, especially when they're not our spouses, and especially when they are not, when those people are married to someone else. That is a grievous sin. Repent and sin no more. The next sin, we use our mouth sometimes to lie, okay? The Word of God says that, by the fruits you will know, and those that lie are children of the devil, and those that speak the truth are children of God. You cannot be a Christian and lie. I don't care. It's not about me, but the Lord doesn't care if it's a white lie, if it's a small lie, a big lie, a tiny lie, or whatever. He does not care. A lie is a lie. And we all know that the father of lies is the devil. So if you are a Christian lying, you need to go to the Lord, repent, sin no more, and ask God to teach you to His truth and to stay there and to actually practice it and live it out. The next sin, idolatry. It's extreme admiration, love, or reverence for something or someone. Oftentimes, we may not pay attention to this, but if we are Christians, our first love needs to be the Lord. It needs to be God the Father, named Yahweh, His Son Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. If we are Christian and we are loving people or things greater than the Lord, oh, you know, I cannot live without, you know, this thing or this person, or, I just idolize, you know, a football team, or I idolize, you know, the celebrity or an artist. That is a sin. Our mouths are to worship the Lord, not worship people or things. So once again, if that is you, repent and sin no more and ask the Lord to teach you, you know, teach you His ways and His thoughts so you can make the Lord your first love. The next sin, enmity. The definition of enmity is the state or feeling of being actively opposed or hostile to someone or something. Okay, if you're hostile with someone, you know, and you're constantly trying to, you know, you have an attitude, if you lash out at people, if you're hostile to people, that is a sin. Once again, if that is you, ask the Lord to, you know, give you self-control, to activate the fruits of the Holy Spirit, and not to be hostile to people. Repent and sin no more. In association with enmity, it's also strife. It's angry or bitter disagreement over fundamental issues and conflict, okay? We are not supposed to be engaging in strife. There's so much of that going on in the body of Christ. That is a sin. So folks, please, if it's going to cause bitter disagreement among the brethren, among your family, your spouses, your children, your loved ones, your neighbors, who your people at work, your coworkers, if that is you, please end it right now. Repent and sin no more. We're supposed to be, you know, Jesus said, blessed are the peacemakers. If we're not creating peace and we're creating strife, you are walking, you're walking in sin, and that needs to be repented. So I'm going to go to the next sin, swindler. It's to take money or property from someone by using lies or tricks. Okay. We all know that we use our mouths to lie, right? And also, this also applies if you are a person who is lying, okay, who's trying to trick people. You know, for your own benefit, you are a swindler. Christians have no business in lying and tricking people for their own benefit. If that is you, once again, repent and sin no more. The next one, jealousy. This is a huge one. And I'm going to keep it real because, my goodness, there is so much jealousy and hate going inside the body of Christ. And that correlates too with envy. Oh my goodness. I talk to people and they're always telling me how people are so jealous and envious of their callings and their ministries and how God's blessing them in their life. And instead of the people around them blessing them, they're just throwing word curses because of their jealousy, because of their envy. And if that is you, if you are full of envy, if you're full of hate, if you're full of jealousy, please, that in itself is a grievous sin. You know, because, you know, remember that envy is what the devil had. The devil had envy towards God, you know? And guess what happened to the devil? He got kicked out of heaven. So here's the thing, envy and jealousy and hate, that is not from the Lord. If that is you, if you are struggling with that, then there might be a chance that you might have to get delivered from that spirit, from that demonic spirit that's trying to, you know, torment you and not allowing you to live in peace. You need to repent of that and ask the Lord to give you His heart, His eyes, and ears to love on all people. And when you see people being blessed, you love on them. You're not living your life full of hatred and jealousy and hate. Next one, the next sin, outburst of anger. The definition of that is a violent expression of feeling, okay? If you are a person that suffers from anger, if let's say you had a bad day, you cannot lash out on people. You cannot have these outbursts and these violent expressions of anger towards people. It is a sin, okay? So once again, repent and sin no more. The next sin, dispute. It's a disagreement, an argument, or debate. You know, so many people are debating back and forth. You know, whether you want to minister to someone, you're debating. You know, look, we're not supposed to be debating with anyone. We're not supposed to engage in disagreement or argument, especially if arguing and disagreements and debating, if it's going to lead people to further tension and resentment and unforgiveness, this is an area that we need to be careful. And if you see that a dispute may arise, let's just pray, forgive, walk away, and just move on. Ask the Lord to forgive you of that and just sin no more. The next sin, which is in association with dispute, is dissension. It's disagreement that leads to discord. Okay, that is a sin. We're not to create dissension. So once again, walk away. If you see people that are going to come at you and they're trying to set you up to get you to speak, and it's going to create an argument, be smart. Ask the Lord, ask the Holy Spirit to give you discernment, you know, so you can take caution if people are trying to set you up by creating an argument, creating a fight, okay? If the last thing that we want is to get ourselves in dissension, And if you have been doing that, please, once again, go to the Lord and ask God to just, to forgive you, repent, and sin no more. The next one is faction. It's a state of conflict within an organization of dissension. Now, here's the thing. The Bible clearly states that we should have no favorites inside the body of Christ. And unfortunately, there are a lot of cliques inside the church. There's a clique with the worship team, a clique with missionaries, a clique with, you know, the pastor, the youth pastor, whatever it is. There are cliques. And when there are cliques or there are little groups of favoritism, this automatically opens up for the opportunity of a faction to take place. It's a state of conflict with an organization, okay? So it is important that we abide in what the Word of God says, that we should not have cliques, we should have no favorites, we should all treat people equally, and it's best that we don't create any factions, because what happens is it just opens up the portals to create people to talk, and once they start talking, it just rolls down the hill from there, and that's not what we want. The next one is slander. And the definition of that is make false or damaging statements about someone. My goodness, folks, please, church, stop slandering one another. You know, if the world does it, that's the world. But we are children of the light of the living God. We are children that are supposed to be the salt of the earth. And so many of us keep slandering one another. They slander, making these false statements against someone. You know, if you are engaged in this, this is an abomination. This is on the precipice of lies. Deception. This is evil. Please, if this is you, repent and sin no more. The next one in association with slander is gossip. And the definition for that is casual or unconstrained conversation or reports about other people, typically involving details that are not confirmed as being true. I cannot tell you how many people I come across and they tell me their stories, how they've been hurt by the church. And a lot of the times it has to do with gossip, slander, envy of people. This has to stop. We cannot continue gossiping, about one another that can hurt people. I've been a victim of gossip. I was a victim of envy. I've been a victim of word curses. I've been a victim of people who had jealousy, against me. And it nearly killed me. So once again, please, folks, let's not gossip. We must repent of that and sin no more. The next two are anger and wrath, and it's a strong feeling of annoyance, displeasure, and hostility. And the definition of wrath is intense anger, usually on an epic scale. This is where we need to be led by the Spirit and not our flesh. We can, no matter how bad your day was, whether you lost your job, whether, your boss was rude, or whatever it is, we must not allow our anger to overtake our flesh and to literally use our mouths to lash on people. Because once those words come out, you can't get them back. Okay? And especially if you get to the point of wrath, which is extreme, intense anger. Okay? That's very scary. Because, my goodness, if you can't control your mouth, let alone control your actions, your physical actions, and this could have really dire consequences. So it's best that, we just go to the Lord, ask Him to give us strength, patience, and to activate the fruits of the Holy Spirit so we're not committing the sin that can lead to opening our mouths through the form of anger and wrath. Please repent and sin no more. The next one is obscenity, okay? It's an extremely offensive word or expression. Okay, no Christian should be coming out of their mouths any F-bombs, S-bombs, all those curse words that you see in the movies and the TVs and the music videos or whatever it is. If common culture is being profane, it's being obscene. As a Christian, our mouths need to be pure, just like our hearts need to be pure. And if you're still struggling with that, please go to the Lord so He can teach you and ask Him to purify you and to cleanse you. No Christian, should be watching entertainment that is profane and obscene, because it's just a matter of time that those spirits from those movies and TV shows and music that you may be listening to that has profane talk and it's vulgar and obscene, it messes with you in your spirit. And you are entertaining these demonic spirits and evil spirits to come into your life and to just, you're opening up portals to yourself. We need to have our temples clean. Our bodies are our temples, our eyes, everything, our whole being needs to be pure. So please, cleanse your home. If you are a Christian that is watching, listening, or entertaining things that are profane or obscene, ask the Lord to forgive you of that and throw that garbage away, and ask the Lord to purify your eyes, ears, mind, body, soul, heart, and spirit to Jesus Christ. So next thing I'm going to just go into really quickly here, it's boastful. The definition of that, as we all know, is showing excessive pride and self-satisfaction in one's achievements, possessions, or abilities, okay? If you are a Christian, seriously, there's no need for you to boast. The Word of God says that the only one we can boast is boast in the Lord. Let me give you an example of what boasting in the Lord is like. Lord, you are amazing. God, I thank you because you are the Almighty God. You're the Alpha and the Omega, the creator of the heavens and earth. God, I delight in you, Lord. That is boasting in God. God is amazing. Oh, God answers prayers. God does miracles. Oh, God is just so, he is so creative. That's several examples of how we boast in the Lord. Now, I'm going to give you an example of what a Christian should not be saying. And I've seen this. Yes, I am blessed. Oh, you know, God has blessed me with this. God has blessed me with that. And I'm so favored and I'm so blessed and I'm just so anointed and I'm that's wrong. That's wrong. Because that blessing doesn't belong to you. It belongs to the Lord. The glory is His. The power is His. You can't be a Christian being arrogant and prideful. Oh, God has blessed me. Yes, I am blessed. No, it's wrong. It's wrong. We're supposed to walk in humility. So if there is any arrogance or pride and just that boastful attitude as a Christian, whether it's your anointing, whether it's your ministry, whether it's your prophetic mantle, whether it's your family, whether it's your marriage, whether it's your job, your home, or whatever it is, look, I'm happy if God is blessing you. I rejoice with you. But at the end of the day, all those blessings do not belong to us. It comes from God. And let me tell you, just as God gives, He takes away. Okay? We need to walk in humility. We are servants of God. And I'm tired of seeing so many Christians being so arrogant and have no sensitivity when they approach other Christians who perhaps are in the valley. And all it takes is one arrogant Christian that's on the mountain and he's like, he or she's like, oh, I'm so anointed. I'm so blessed. And there's no compassion. There's no humility. There's no prudence. There's no caution. There's no sensitivity to maybe the Christian that may be hearing or seeing you or the non-believer who may be in the valley. And let me tell you, if God puts you in that mountain, let me tell you this. God can put you back in that valley. There's no need to get arrogant. God puts you in places and God will take you out. So please, can we walk in humility moving forward? God, Jesus was God and He came in the flesh as man, but He was also God and He was humble. So if we are called children of the Lord, we need to walk in that humility. My goodness, I just see it all the time. It's just unbelievable. The next sin, quarrel. You know, it's an angry argument or disagreement, typically between people who are usually on good terms. Okay, what do I mean? What does this mean? Okay, let's say you have siblings in Christ, and or just, you know, you have friends, and that you're talking about a topic that perhaps may be controversial, or look, you see your point of view, or that person sees your point of view, it could be about anything. It's best that if you are not going to persuade that person to see your side, or vice versa, guess what? Cut it. Just be like, oh, okay, I see your point. Okay, well, I respect your point. Please respect mine. And guess what? You bless them, you pray for them, and you walk away. There's no need for you to start quarreling. Oh, but, you know, I have this and I have that and you're wrong and she's right. And no, no, it's a sin. God doesn't like it. Stop it. Repent and sin no more. Deceit. The action or practice of deceiving someone by concealing or misrepresenting the truth. No Christian has any business to practice deception. Deception is a straight up lie, okay? If you have been a person that has committed deception with anyone for that matter, please repent and sin no more. Deception is a very, very big big sin in the Lord's eyes. Do not be fooled, okay? Just go to the Lord and just ask Him to teach you His ways and His thoughts and sin no more. The next one, hypocrisy. This is my favorite because I've seen so many in the body of Christ. A bunch of hypocrites. They're the first ones who say, they have these holier than thou attitudes. And on top of that, they're the ones that are always saying, I'm not a sinner. I am perfect. I am holy. If the rapture happens, I'm going up. If God calls me home, I can't wait to be home. And then the other side of them too is that, look at that sinner. Look at that pagan. Look at that homosexual. Look at that prostitute. Look at that adulterer. Look at that person. Oh, I'm so perfect. Blah, 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 blah. And guess what? That's a sin. Oh, man. So many hypocrites. The same people that we have been called by the Lord Jesus Christ to be truth and spirit believers, to be humble, to be meek, to be peacemakers, to speak life over people, to love on people, to warn. in truth and love and in spirit, the same people to be the light and the salt of the earth. Oh man, so many of us are not. We are so not. We're the first ones. We are judging. We are criticizing them. We have these two huge planks in our eyes. And yeah, we think that everyone's disgusting. We think that everyone is wrong but us. Oh, I see it all the time. I see Christians all the time who are criticizing the pagans in the world, but yet they're a bunch of fornicators. They're shacking up with their boyfriends and girlfriends. They're watching pornography. They're a bunch of liars. They're judging everyone. On top of it, they're stealing. They are, they have these holier than thou attitudes. I mean, and the list goes on and on and on. And I'm just like, oh Lord, have mercy on us. It's bad. We're walking like a bunch of hypocrites. And then you wonder why so many ministries and pastors and preachers, oh, how come the world doesn't want to come to us? We're having such a, yeah, because Christian, because we're a bunch of hypocrites. That's why the world doesn't want to come to us. We're not practicing what we preach. And I got to tell you, I've been saved for almost 3 years. And I remember a while ago, I told the Lord, I said, Lord, now that I'm in your light and now I see the truth, help me when I approach people, they see you in me. The last thing that I want to do is hurt who you are, Lord. And the last thing that I want to come across is a walking hypocrite. Jesus, you hated hypocrites. I never want to ever be like a hypocrite. You know, I don't want to be one. You despise them. And the body of Christ needs to understand that, you know, Jesus has no tolerance for hypocrites. We need to stop. With our mouths, we exalt ourselves. But in reality, our actions are despicable. They're disgusting, okay? And that's what comes out of that comes out of our mouths. It's just completely vile, and we need to repent of that. So please, no more hypocrisy. Last but not least, it's the last one. It's perjury, and it's the offense of willfully telling an untruth in a court after having taken an oath or affirmation. So if you have been in a situation where you were responsible to say something about someone in a court setting, I believe, and you knew that person was innocent, but yet you decided to tarnish that person's reputation or innocence by your lie, that's perjury, okay? Please go to the Lord, ask Him to forgive you of your sins, come clean with the Lord, and ask the Lord to guide you how to resolve that matter. Because if there's an innocent person that you have lied under oath, and that person is being punished unfairly, And it derives from your own actions, especially coming out of your mouth, then it's best just to come clean with God, like today, this moment, if you're in that situation, and just ask the Lord to guide you on how to clear the whole situation and possibly even clear the record for that person or people you have hurt. So that's basically it. I just wanted to kind of give you some quick scriptures on this to kind of keep in mind. Exodus 27, it talks about not using the name of the Lord in vain. In Luke 12:10, it talks about the dangers of blaspheming the Holy Spirit. In Galatians 5:19-21, it talks about the acts of the flesh and how those that practice it will not inherit the kingdom of God. In 2 Corinthians 12:20, it also continues about the acts of the flesh, and Colossians 3:8, in addition to 1 Peter 2:1. And last but not least, it's important, this one, because especially if you are married, husband and wife, it says in Colossians 3:19, husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Husbands, if you're out there, you know, love your wives, you know, and wives, love your husbands. Use your mouths to, you know, edify them, to support them, to comfort them, to pray for them. But don't use your mouths to tear each other apart. You know, be patient with your spouses, both your husbands and your wives. I mean, that is your helper. That is the head. The man is the head of the wife, just like Christ is the head of the church. And we need to know our roles. And most importantly, not only that we know it, but we live it out. So last but not least, I wanted to kind of lead you to James chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. Definitely read it. It's about taming the tongue, because remember in Proverbs 18:21, it states that the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. I hope this message has blessed you. I hope it just spoke to you. I mean, this really spoke to me. I mean, the Lord really spoke to me today as I wrote down this message. It was all Him, and I gave Him the praise and glory, and I know that this message also applies to me. And at the end of the day, I need to abide in Him and honor and obey the Lord, because once again, He's not a respecter of persons. So feel free to share this video with your friends and family. And if you need prayer, feel free to message me. I'll be more than happy to pray for you. And I will be posting more videos in the hours and days to come. Have a wonderful day. Love you all. And I bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.